Hello, my name is Dezso, and I'd like to invite you to join me in a concert and a celebration of some of the great composers of the 18th and 19th century. We'll look at some composers such as Johann Sebastian Bach and Mozart, but we're going to begin with my favorite composer, and that's Beethoven. And we're going to begin with one of Beethoven's most famous works. And the first time that anybody ever heard this work, reviewer wrote that when he heard this piece, it made him think that he was possibly on a boat an evening on a lake in Switzerland gazing at the moon. And the piece became known as the Moonlight Sonata. So Beethoven's Moonlight Sonata, first movement.
Thank you.
My next work is a sonata by Mozart. And Mozart was an incredible pianist, and he wrote many very beautiful piano sonatas. And this is usually the first sonata that people start out with, pianists start out with, of his 23, 24 or so sonatas. This is his sonata number 15 in C major. And here he goes. Beethoven called this his tragic sonata, and tragic in French is pathétique, and this is one of Beethoven's greatest and most loved works, the middle movement of his pathétique sonata.
Thank you.
We continue with some playful works of the young Mozart. And I'd like to invite you to join me in a work done by Mozart when he was 10 years old. Mozart was a child prodigy who began playing piano about age of 3 or 4 and writing compositions by age 5. He was challenged when he was in Switzerland with his family to write a composition at the spur of the moment. And someone gave him the following musical theme. And challenged the 10-year-old Mozart to write a composition right then and there on that musical theme. And so this is something that the 10-year-old Mozart came up with right on the spot. Because it's not a serious funeral march, it's a joke funeral march. Everything about this work is exaggerated. Even the title, Mozart calls it, in French and Italian, he calls it his Marche Funèbre del Signor Maestro Contrapunto, or his funeral march for the Grand Master of Counterpoint. So this is a work I've always enjoyed by Mozart. It's a joke funeral march and a piece of exaggerated contrasts. It's a lot of fun. I hope you enjoy it. Schumann. Robert Schumann was one of the great pianists of the 19th century, great composer, but unfortunately he injured himself in his early 20s. Schumann was such a great pianist, he used to do musical interpretations of his friends. He would gather his friends around the piano and he would say, okay, which friend is this, and just do like a musical interpretation of one of his friends, and they everybody always knew exactly who he was intending when he would do these musical jokes about them. But when you're developing your fingers for piano, the hardest fingers to develop are these two fingers of both hands, especially this one, we call this finger 4, ring finger. And it takes a long time to get these fingers strong, especially finger 4 over here. And so Robert Schumann rigged a device by putting these strings in the fingers, and he tried to very aggressively play, and it ended up crippling both of his hands. So Schumann could never play again, but he had his wife, Clara Schumann, was also an incredible pianist. And so she became basically the performer for Schumann's piano works. This is an excerpt from a set of works that Schumann wrote that I've always really enjoyed. They're called Scenes from Childhood, and this is one of those compositions. Moving to another great pianist of the 19th century, Frédéric Chopin, born in Poland, but spending most of his life over in France. And of a set of 24 preludes that Chopin wrote, this is one in E minor. Back to Mozart. Mozart, one of the greatest geniuses who ever lived. There are some people consider Mozart to be possibly the greatest genius that anybody human ever born. Let's take a look at a couple of works by Mozart that really interested me, especially when I discovered Mozart as a teen, and became very interested in both of these works, and I was determined to one day learn how to play them. And one of them, it's a very popular and very difficult work by Mozart, I'm going to play the main themes from it, is Mozart called it his Rondo alla Turca, usually with something called it his Turkish March. Major themes from this work. Thank you. Another work that I discovered by Mozart as a teen that became one of my favorites is a work of great contrast by Mozart. Slow parts, fast parts, happy parts, sad parts. And Mozart called this a fantasia or fantasy. So Mozart's Fantasy in D minor. My final work is one of the most popular works for piano. in the repertoire. This is a work by Beethoven. It is one of his most beautiful, and we don't know very much about it, other than that it was written for a young lady by the name of Elise. So this is Beethoven's work for Elise.
Thank you.